the bars like I'm Tony Danza. Everybody tryna tell me what I stand for. What I stand for. Know me, homie, you don't want war. Candy paint with the white on top. Lambo doors or the woo-wop drop. If you busy plotting on what I got, kicking your door, that's what you got.
Welcome to CX Works 32. We have another super exciting class for you today to improve your core strength and stability. Teaching, we have Aaron, Renee, Dan, and I'm Corey. For today's class, you need a light weight plate and a resistance band. Let's connect our brain to our core and get warm. Come on down to the floor. Feet hip width apart and close to your butt. Hands under lower back at belly button level. Press your back into your hands and brace your abdominals. Front foot lifts, toe tap up, down, up, down. Toes tap softly. Small movement. Move from your hip and keep the knee at a fixed angle. We start with the C crunch combo. Feet down, fingers to temples, up, cross crawl front, C crunch center, cross crawl back, knees stop above hips. As you crunch up, squeeze ribs to hips. As you cross crawl, lift the back shoulder up and across. In the middle, double pulse. Up, down, cross crawl. Up, down. Fingertips are light on your temples, so you don't pull on your head. Chin's gently tucked. From the top, hands down, front foot. Up, down, tiny taps. Brace abdominals so your lower back stays still. And try this. Walk your feet out a little further. Feel how that loads your core. Then bring them back in. C crunch combo. Single up, cross crawl. So this time, try and spread your elbows really wide. As you twist and as you crunch. And then feel how much harder your abdominals have to work to go full range when you do that. Hold here, bridge. Feet hip width apart and close to butt. Squeeze butt, lift hips to ceiling. Gently press chest to chin, hips pulse. Up, down, up. Every time you lift your hips, squeeze your glutes as hard as you can. Now press down through heels so toes are light and feel the whole back of your body starting to warm. Four more. Right, slowly roll down through the spine, fingers to temples, C crunch combo, singles, up, cross crawl. Now see if you can get a little bit more range in the crunch by squeezing your abdominals. On the cross crawl, pull the elbow back a little further to get more rotation. Double everything. Pulse, double the cross crawl. So not only do we get warm now, moving faster, we wake our brain up, so we're ready for the class. You guys warm? Last time. Middle's definitely warm. All right, grab the back of your thighs, roll up, come into hover. So angle yourselves in towards the center, lying down, elbows under shoulders, fists together, knees hip width apart. Lift hips to shoulder height, brace your abdominals, and you're on knees or toes. Spine is long and straight from the crown of the head to the tailbone. If you're on knees, hold here. If you're on toes, rock forward, and back. Chest towards fists. Shoulder stop over elbows. Pull your shoulders away from your ears and feel your strong upper back muscles squeeze to hold your shoulder blades there. That's going to keep your upper back straight. If you're on your knees, hold still. If you're rocking, lift the front foot, tap it down. Back leg, foot to hip height, 2 points. If you're on the option, lift the leg. Everyone, squeeze abs to keep hips level to the floor. Down to knees, hold, roll onto your back. Crunch sequence, knees over hips, tuck your chin, arms and legs shoot up, out, circle round. Up, out. Chin tucks, head touches down. Tuck your chin, place the head on the floor. As your arms and legs extend, brace abs to keep the lower back close to the floor. As you crunch up, squeeze ribs to hips. Last time, upper body stays still, circle the legs. 4, 3, 2, tailbone lifts. Legs are bent or straight. And you're drawing the circles about the size of a bicycle wheel. Shoulders stay still. Tailbone lifts. Last time. Hold, grab the back of the knees, roll up. Come into hover. So start lying face down. Elbows under shoulders, knees under hips. Knees or toes. Round 2 of 3. Rock forward, 2, back, 2. So the goal of our hover is to strengthen your abdominals by bracing your abs so hard that your lower back doesn't arch towards the floor. So try this for an extra level of stability. Keep hips at shoulder height, tuck tail and squeeze your glutes. Feel how that ramps up your abdominal brace. Now try lifting the leg. Can you feel how the glutes squeeze and brace? Not only stops lower back arching towards the floor, it also keeps hips level as you move. One more. Right, knees down. Come on onto your back. Crunch sequence. Knees over hips. Tuck chin. Arms and legs shoot up, out. Circle. So imagine you're an Olympic springboard diver. You pike and explode out of the pike. As you explode out, feel your abdominals grip hard to stabilize your back and keep it close to the floor. If it's lifting, don't go quite so low. Circles. 4, 3, 2, up. Try and go a little larger as long as the back stays close to the floor. If it's lifting, bend your knees a little bit. This is great, not only for lower abdominal strength, but it's also good for hip mobility. Hold, grab the back of the knees. Last round of 3, come into hover. Elbows under shoulders, knees under hips. Time to fight fatigue. Brace abs, squeeze your butt. Rock it forward. So right about now, your abdominals are gonna be on fire. If you feel like your back's arching towards the floor, then drop to your knees, hold, reset your core, and come up when you're ready. Right, time to fight fatigue. Lift the leg, hang on in there, and just know your core's getting stronger. 4 more reps. Feeling the power and stability in your glutes and abdominals. Last time. Knees down, roll over. Ready for some speed and power. Chin tucks, come on up. Up, out. Now feel how strong your core is and challenge a little bit. How low can you go? How high can you crunch? That extra little bit of range takes your core strength to the next level. Last one. Upper body still, circle the legs. Large circles. Feel the tailbone lift. And your goal is to keep your upper body super quiet and still. Let's have a look. When you keep it quiet, your lower abdominals work twice as hard. Last time, go large. Hold, grab the back of the knees, roll up. Great work.
Well done. Stand up, grab your bands and a light plate for resistance.
All right, then step your right foot onto the bend. Connect the plate with the handle. Start over your right knee. And when you're ready, up and over. And slide back. We call this our resisted rainbow. So rotate from the center of your chest and brace your abs to square your hips to the front.
Really trying to keep the arms straight. So if they're bending, just loose the plate. Big focus on maintaining control.
All right, new move, the dead shot. Check the rhythm, slide across. 3, 2, down to your knee. From corner to corner. And remember, team, a strong ab brace to square your hips.
Our hips move side to side and the knee bends. All the movement comes from the legs. That's what drives us.
All right, it's your last one. Now step your feet in, drop the plate, stepping wood chop. Out and in. Start on top of the knee and stop just above shoulder height. And now bend your standing knee lots. Great job.
The objective is to be explosive. So bend the knees, push the hips back, and then explode out from the base. Drop and pop. 4, 3, 1 out and hold. Wait, well done, check it out. We're gonna hit the second side. Band comes across, left foot steps on, grab your plate. Plate in left hand, take feet wide. Right hand comes down, touch the left knee. Let's hit the rainbow. Up across, and then back. Big circle. Rotating from the center of the chest.
Okay guys, let's have a look behind the sides. The bend tries to pull you back towards your foot. And the plate, straight forward. And that gives you an extra challenge. And your core is doing really, really hard.
Let's hit some parallel wood chops. 3, 2, 1, and touch. A little fatigue kicking in now. Roll the shoulders back down into the ribs and focus on lifting the chest.
Oh yeah, that's my favorite part. We slide from side to side. Drive the rotation from the center. Our entire core is working. Can you feel your obliques engage?
Oh yeah. We got one more gang. All right, quick change. Bring the foot in, drop the plate. Wood chop to the right, out and in. Out and in. Reactive and fast. No plate, so lots of freedom to go big and powerful with the band.
Yes, and here's my challenge. Try to imagine you want to rip the band from your anchor point. Maximum speed. Come on, drive from the bottom. Accelerate to the top. Strong knife. Up and freeze.
One more part.
One more.
Fold the band and stay with Corey for the option. Otherwise, grab a plate. Bring the plate home to the collarbone, elbows under, feet underneath hips. Lateral squat to the right. Step out for 2 and up and in. Left, out, down, up and in. Hips back, chest up, knees out.
Let's add load, slowly press the plate. We came for great benefits. Brace your abs even harder and keep your elbows forward on face. Hey guys, shall we speed it up? Come on, drop and press, change, boom. Now create an upward force with the plate and downward force with your body. Punch, catch, do it again, punch. Come guys, last one and three. Ooh. Well done.
Right, keep your band close. Come on down to the floor. We're gonna strengthen the glute muscles around your hips. Right side on, feet hip width apart and close to your butt. Squeeze butt, lift hips up into bridge. Pulses, hips up, down, up. Every time you lift your hips, squeeze them as hard as humanly possible. Now feel your heels, press them down, toes are light, and feel how that accentuates the glute contraction. You guys ready for some single leg training? Weight shift into your back leg, lift front knee over hip, scoop the leg, out, up, out and up. Knee stops over hips, squeeze your butt hard. Your goal is to keep your hips level to the floor and still. If that's twisting, grab your hips and hold them there or drop back down to bridge. Time to go down, one more time. Let's go down, hip pulse, up, down, up. Give it all you got with every hip squeeze. Now if you start to feel it in your lower back a little bit, try this, tuck your tail. Shorten the movement, and that'll work glutes more. Right, weight shift into front leg, back leg lifts. Scoop down and up. Now still and level your hip stack. Oh yeah, looking strong. Now feel the load building in your glutes. Can you feel it building? So we just wind them up. Because when we wind our glutes up with load, we make them stronger. Right, last eight hip bridges, foot down, up, down, up. Give it everything. Drive down through the heels. Right, hold, roll down through your spine. Coming up to standing. Grab your band or no band, option is yours. Step into the band, feet under hips. Pull the handles right up to your waist, bend knees, chest up. Make sure you got room to move. Weight shift left. Right heel slides back and circles around. Tap, circle, tap. Brace your abdominals to keep your hips facing forward. Now can you bend your standing leg a little? That gives you stability and keeps you upright. Now try keeping the foot off. Good, can you make it bigger? Excellent. One more time, weight shift to the opposite leg. Heel goes back, tap, big circle. Now right now, your body wants to break out, hold it still, and control the movement by synchronizing your core muscles. So feel your abs brace, hip and adductor working hard. Last four, can you keep it still? It's a competition. Wicked. Right, new move. Take feet outside, hips, squat pulse. Down, down, right leg lifts. Left leg. Pick your chest up for great posture. Squeeze butt as you stand. So the heel goes back 2 inches. You guys wanna fire your glutes up at full throttle? Try this, butt down right above knees. Explode like you're gonna jump. Can you feel the power in your glutes? Excellent. Four more to fire them up. Three. Last time. Down and hold. Slowly up. Whoa, glutes on fire.
All right, let's focus on the obliques. So for this track, you want a small or a medium weight plate handy to add load. Coming down to the ground. Extend the legs to 45. Fingertip temple. Chin in and crunch up. You're twisting to the front leg, to the center, and now the back.
I'm supposed to call you, but
rear shoulder comes up and across towards the opposite thigh. Keeping the elbows wide, rotate from the center of your chest. Now alternatively, bend the knees and toe tap in between each set. this might give you the added boost that you need to rotate. And working deep into those rotator muscles, making the obliques really strong here. We're going to pick up the tempo, a 3-2-1 rhythm. Go. 3-2-1 change. Bring the knees in towards the hips and then actively drive the legs away as you rotate. One more. Hold. Great work. All right, just setting up a side hover. Option to add a weight plate here. Elbow directly underneath your shoulder. Bent knee in line with the hip. Top leg straight. Plate in hand. Now lift your bottom hip. Extend the top arm. Brace abs and hips square. We're rolling into hover on your knees. And then come back up to side hover. Keep the abs braced and the hips lifted. Now you can do this on the toes where you split the legs, roll from the side of the foot onto the toe. Hold side hover, four hip lifts. Four, three, two. Now the body rolls together. Hips move, chest turns again. Now really push the forearm into the ground, especially as you're rolling down. Keep the top hip lifted, really putting pressure into the underside oblique. And you're threading the plate to the elbow. Ooh. Oh yeah, there's the pressure in the muscle. Hold. Drop. That's a nice little bite. Let's do that on the other side. Turn, extend legs to 45. Tuck the chin, fingertip temple, you're crunching up. Twist the front leg to the center and now the back. You're creating a triangle between the elbows and the tip of the head. Like holding that position. Almost squeezing the shoulder blades back. So you can get maximum rotation here. It's what we call the hollow position. Because you're working through that mid and lower abdominal at the same time as you're twisting, you're working the sides. All right? Good. Now, triple rhythm. 3-2-1. 3-2-1, change. If you find the shoulders starting to collapse, go back to that really wide elbow position. Last one. Hold. Great work. All right, back in the side, hover. Elbow, shoulder, knee, leg. And if you feel good, plate in hand. And let's go here straight away. Now try this. That top arm, take the shoulders away from the ears. And now pull the lats down in towards the spine, squeeze the shoulder blades, and roll into the hover. Down, knees, or scissor stance on the toes. It's like you're trying to thread a piece of cotton through the eye of a needle. Hold here, lift your hips, go. Four. Three, and now let's thread the plate all the way towards that back elbow, stimulating the obliques. Push that forearm hard into the ground. That's going to strengthen the shoulder in this position. You've got long legs. You're squeezing the glutes. You're squeezing your quads. And you're creating space between the ground and the plate. One more, you guys have got this. Now up and hold. Gently release. Beautiful work. So let's continue to work our core and the muscles of our back. You'll need your band. Come on down, stretch the band and take the knees slightly wider than the hips. Cross the handles out the waist. Now you've got tension in the band. Shoulders back and down, brace abs, tip forward from the hips, elbows are up, extend from the elbow and lift. And L row. Take the hips back towards the heels. As you tip forward, squeeze the shoulder blades.
All right, guys, just a row. Stay down for four. Four, three, two, stay down, extend your arms. A small movement, thumbs face inwards.
$100,000 on the tabletop. Have price my whip, same price my watch. Got no jumbo.
Now we're going to put those two moves together. One L row, rise up. Now brace abs, tip forward from the hip, four pulse. Four, three, two, one.
Slab boy coming down, mom hot. Everybody say that I gotta restart.
Working deep into the muscles of the mid and the upper back in this position. Keeping tension on the band, especially as you rise up. Now you can take your elbows as wide and as high as you like, as long as your upper body remains still.
Let's go back to our L roll. Bend, extend and slowly resist. The tempo is quite slow and that allows to keep every single muscle fiber under tension and to control the movement. Beautiful.
Right, one more set, let's finish with isolations. Pulse, four, three. That's the one. Full range release at the bottom and then a wide high pull as you come up. Boom. This is great movement, great technique. And time. Band down, lay on the belly, feet together, squeeze the glutes, arms out to the side, reach forward, pull in and then beautifully unwind. Keep the glutes squeezed hard to protect the spine. Pull the elbows in towards the ribs and then squeeze the shoulder blades. You're lifting, isolating, and then lift a little bit higher if you can.
Okay team, put one hand on top of the other, head down, and start flutter kick your legs. Now squeeze your glute tight and try to lift your knees off the floor by squeezing your thighs and just swimming.
Good, now keep kicking your legs, take the arms wide, reach forward, pull in and then unwind again. Now if you're finding it's a little challenging on the coordination, drop the legs and just maintain the upper body. Otherwise, kneecaps off the ground, pull the thighs up, keep kicking. Now hold here, just the legs. Kick, kick,
kick, kick, kick.
And hands under shoulders, sit the tailbone back, just release the tension, and then gently curl up through the spine. Beautiful work.
Absolutely awesome class. That was CX Works 32. You've just fatigued your core, so avoid weight training. Thank you for joining us. Until next time, see you later.
Hey guys, we also have two amazing bonus tracks that you can swap out like for like. This is bonus track two. You're gonna need a lightweight plate for later on in the track. Come on down. Let's set up for a hover. So face us on your bellies, elbows under shoulders, fists together, and come on up. Big brace of the abs, back is long and straight, hips are in line with the shoulders. If you're feeling really good and want a challenge, come on up to your toes. Two big sets in this track, focusing on core strength and hitting the stabilizers. Thank you. Roll the shoulders back. Couple of big breaths because we're here for a while. All right, everybody, come down to your knees. Walk your right arm out in front. Walk your left arm out in front. We call this extended plank. Big brace of the abs. Shoulder tap. Right hand to left shoulder. Up, up, down, switch. Good, body still, hips and shoulders square to the ground. Hear it in the music. Extra challenge. Up on the toes. Finding the rhythm. Really focusing on keeping the body still. If you find your body's rocking, just come down to your knees. Last couple. One more. Well done, everybody. Come down. Roll onto your back plate or no plate in the back hand. Arms straight, anchor your front arm, knees in line with hips, crunch up, extension, combo. Open out, pike up, open, and then crunch in. Open, pike, open, and crunch. Lower back presses towards the floor. And then as you crunch in, ribs to hips. If it's too much load, lose the plate. Super slow. 4, 3, 2, 1, up. Good. Super slow. One more like that. Last new move, two hands on the plate, split the legs and scissor the legs. Good, long legs. This is a little too intense. You can just tap the knees instead. One more challenge. Crunch the upper body and hold it here. Lots of load and tension now. Tuck in the chin. Last four, three, two, one, recover. Drop the plate, hands behind thighs, come on up. We okay? Ready to go again? Come down onto your forearms, belly down, draw up into hover. Knees or toes? What are you gonna go for, Ali? Big brace of the abs, shoulders back. Isn't a hover awesome? Extra conditioning. Also working our butts and our hammies. Also good for strength and posture. Doesn't it feel amazing too? Come on down. Take your left arm out. Take your right arm out. Extended hover. Now, let's get a little aggressive. The further you take your hands, the more load, the harder it's gonna be. Shoulder tap, left arm up and down. Really pressing the palms into the floor. Squeezing the abs really tight. And if you'd like the challenge, there it is. Hips square. How good does it feel with your hands out further from your body? Extra load, extra tension, extra strength. Super reactive for our core. Last one. Well done, come down. Last part, grab the plate, change around to the other side. Plates in the back arm, front arm anchors, knees in, line with your hips, crunch up, combo extension, out, up, down, and in. Remember, if this is too much load, you can lose the plate and bend the knees. Really focusing on bracing, keeping the feet together, tucking in the chin. challenging your strength. Super slow. 4, 3, 2. Tailbone lifts. Who's got it? Breathing. Hear it in the music. Ready for the last part? Two hands on, split and switch. Whew, here we go. Lower abs are firing and engaged. Home stretch, guys. One little challenge to go before we get there. Crunch up. Hang in there. Everything is fatigued, but this is how we get strong core. 4, 3, 2, 1. Plate down. Well done. Hands behind thighs, gently roll up. Well done, everybody.
Bonus track 5. Music, please. Come on down to the floor. Let's strengthen the rotator muscles of your trunk. Arms out wide, palms up, shoulders anchored, legs bent or straight. Top leg, lower it to the front. Slow, and then back up. Change legs. Just lowering to halfway. Legs scissor. Your thighs are tight. As you come to the front, focus on the back shoulder, staying anchored to the floor. If it's lifting, reduce the range a little bit or bend the knees a fraction. And then when you've got that control, push the range a little bit. You guys ready for some speed? Back leg, throw it to the floor. Down, slowly up. Change legs. Then feel your abs decelerate the movement. So your abs act like a handbrake to decelerate the movement. Then feel the abdominals fire up as you slow your legs down. Right, new move. Knees together, side hopper. Elbow under shoulder, lift bottom hip, arm and leg extend. Now try this, tuck chin, roll to the back. Elbow under shoulder, lift bottom hip. Go again, brace abs, so hips and shoulders roll as one. Hips square to the front. If that's uncomfortable to roll, stay up on your elbows. Come again, roll. Now this time, stay here. The only thing that moves is the top arm and leg. Come in, out. Can you keep your hips facing forward? Now try that to the back. Slowly roll. Feel that bottom hip lifting. Only thing that moves is arm and leg in, out, in, and out. Let's go faster. 1, 2, 3, 4, in, out, in, out. Go again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tuck and roll. Now push the elbow down through the floor to stabilize your shoulder girdle. This is playtime. Great agility for our bodies to keep us young. 2 more. Can you feel the bottom hip and oblique working to keep you lifted? 1 more time. Stronger obliques. Right, lie on your back. Take your arms wide. Knees bent or straight. Back leg, bring it to the front. Slowly down and up. To the back. Speed time. Throw the leg down. Feel the abs catch and then pull you back up. Feel what happens to your abs when we move this fast. They grab a hold of your spine and ribs and they pull you back up with lots of strength and power. 1 more time. Right, new move. Flutter kick the legs, keeping them straight. Coming to the front slow. Come right down, shoulder anchored, then come back up. Right over to the back. Now try this, keep going, but push down through the hands and shoulders even harder. If the shoulder lifts, bend the knees so you can reduce the load. Now feel the strength in your obliques. Can you go a little further? A little bit further. Come on to the back. Strengthen our core to the beat of a drum. Keep going. Last one. Bow, 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 bow. How's the core? Feeling strong? Last rep. Strong. All the way to the end. Done. Good work. Coming up.